Alright, welcome to this tutorial, and this tutorial will be covering swapping out texture 2Ds, unpacking packing for texture 2Ds, looking at models, animations, data files, all located within the shared asset folders. So what we're looking at today in this tutorial will be swapping out the texture 2D of this Earth to a moon graciously provided by Torf. So first, you need to get the files themselves. So to access your Hardspace Shipbreaker files, you right click Hardspace Shipbreaker, Properties, Local Files, Browse. Your main files you'll be looking at is these. The ones in this tutorial we'll be looking at is the Shared Assets and Resource files. Levels are just used for the HAB, the Bay and all that sort of stuff. Global Managers, these are linked into the DLLs and data files. So today we'll be looking at Shared Assets 8, as that contains the Planet Texture ID. In order to look at this, you need to use the tools described in the description, download both of them, you can use them accordingly. Let's look at the tools then. Asset Studio. This allows us to access the assets file within the Hardspace Shipbreaker directory. So let's say Shared Assets 8. This unpacks it, allows us to view into it all the textures, the models, animations, and all that sort of stuff. It allows us to make a dump, allows us to export, and that's practically it. The beauty of this program is we get a preview, if you will. So let's say, for example, looking at the planet cutout, which is what we're replacing today. See, we get a beautiful preview of Beautiful Earth. So what we're going to do now is right-click, export selected assets. That allows us to export the asset we want and what we want to replace. So let's stick it here. Right, for the other stuff. So export, let's say for example we wanted to make a dump of everything inside, so you can easily look at it through the Windows Explorer. Go export, all assets, you can do that accordingly, or you can make a dump file. Now, what we want to do now is we have the Earth, we want to swap it out with the Torf Moon texture. So let's open up paint.net or Photoshop or any graphical editing software. Let's drag this beauty in. And let's also drag the moon texture. So what we do is replace the Earth with this texture, ensuring it's the same size, more or less. Remember, the file has to be the same file name and the pixel resolution. So once this is ready, we're going to export Planet Cutout, replace it. And now we have the texture ready for packing. So first, now we need to go into Unity Asset Bundle Extractor. This allows us to edit the files and look at them. And now we're going to look at Shared Assets 8. This will allow you to swap out textures, view the aspect ratios, perform exports. You can also do previews, you can get a modding tool set up. Just be aware, this method will only work for texture 2Ds at the moment. We're currently working at methods to import and repackage models and data scripts, though we have been able to get into DLLs within the game directory, so we can edit, for example, thruster speed, the kill zone, so when it tells you to return to the workplace and all that sort of stuff. But anyway, this loading will take a while. If you want to skip ahead, please do. Right, we're in. This allows you to swap out the texture accordingly. So what we can do is search for Planet Cutout, as we found in the Asset Studio. Now it's here. So we've selected it, press Plugins, Edit. load texture, having loaded the texture we just made, which is this beauty. So now we're going to press OK. Normal. This will effectively now edit the actual asset file within the asset bundle. It will then, once we press save, it will repackage and we can use that in the game directory. Unity will read that, so it's a valid form of modding those files. Just remember, once you mod it in, it will perform one file, so if you wanted to have multiple mods editing files simultaneously, we're going to need a patcher. A patcher is underway by fellow members. We also have a Bepinex patcher which has been used, but it's unreliable. We don't have a tutorial for it yet. So now, I'm going to press save, shared assets 8, and now we have it here. So now we're going to open up the hardware shipbreaker folder and we're going to swap out the file. So we're going to go into here and it's shared assets 8. So now we're going to make a copy of it. Just as a backup so you can restore it easily once you drag the new one in. Right, so that's effectively in. So the Unity will now read that and allow us to use it as a form of texture for the Earth. Now we can load into the game and see the result. Again, if you have any questions about this process or any sort of questions about modding in general, just hop into the modding discussion channel within the Hardspace Shipbreaker Discord. There's plenty of friendly people there to answer your question. Well, to the best of our ability, we don't know much, but I'm sure we can still help you. We're still in the way of exploration. It's the early stages of modding. So let's head into free play, mackerel. We're going to hop around and see our beautiful moon. Now, in theory, this method will apply to textures like these. Once you find them, that beautiful floating thing, the textures of the mackerel, the jacks, the texture of everything around here. And yeah, I mean, the possibilities are endless, really. There will be more tutorials coming out, especially for DLL, since that's a big part of the game, which is editing the code to get us to add new content is like stickers and all that sort of stuff. But yeah, I mean, hopefully this introduces you to modding. You can start modding your own HUDs, customizable stuff in game. Again, if you have any questions, just ask. Enjoy your day, Cutter.